Hey guys, I'm very excited to talk to you guys about this newest show on Netflix. Basically, it was from YouTube, but now it's on Netflix. It was kind of free, but now it's even more free because I have my sister's login. And this show is called Cobra Kai. And this is a recap of episode one, Ace Degenerate. The show opens up with a flashback from December 19th, 1984, as we see a young Daniel LaRusso give Johnny Lawrence a crane kick illegally to the face. Flash forward 30 years later, Johnny Lawrence wakes up in his rundown apartment, and then he makes the breakfast of champions. That's right, fried bologna. As Johnny's walking to his car on his way to work, he meets Miguel.
Hey, I'm Miguel. My family and I just moved into 109.
Great, more immigrants.
Miguel is a scrawny teenager with braces. So you know where this is going. That's right. They're gonna go all, she's all that.
Got 6 weeks to turn her into the prom queen.
Gentlemen, we have a winner.
As Johnny is driving to work, he sees on his left side, oh my God, it's a huge billboard of, that's right, his arch enemy, Daniel LaRusso. And now Johnny is all flushed. He's like, what the F is going on? My arch enemy has his own billboard. He's successful and I'm eating fried bologna? This whole thing with the billboard makes Johnny have a very bad day. He cannot get his mind off of Daniel LaRusso. So much so that Johnny is getting all flustered at work. And then he eventually gets fired.
No. I didn't call her a bitch. I said she was bitching at me. There's a difference. You're firing me because of that bitch?
And then we see Johnny at the local convenience store ordering his dinner, which is a slice of pizza. Meanwhile, Miguel is at the same store. What are the chances? Outside of the store, Johnny Lawrence is enjoying his slice of dirty pizza. And then we see Miguel getting pushed out of the convenience store by a bunch of guys because Miguel inadvertently baited them out. And he said, hey, we're in high school. We cannot buy beer. As the gang starts beating up on him, they throw Miguel onto Johnny Lawrence's car. That prompts Johnny Lawrence to get up. He's like, yo, what the heck, dude? As Johnny drops his pizza, the inner Cobra Kai comes out. And Johnny starts beating up on the gang that are beating up on young Miggy Miguel.
Let's get him.
He starts doing his karate moves that he hasn't done in 30 years, and it is badass. Johnny Lawrence beats up all these five kids by himself. And then the cops come and arrest him, because you can't really beat up on a bunch of kids. The next day, Johnny is bailed out by his evil stepfather, Ed Asner, who breaks an entering and is waiting at Johnny's house. Ed Asner says this is the final straw. I'm sick and tired of taking care of you and bailing you out, Johnny Lawrence. So he gets his checkbook out. He writes him a check for a bunch of dollars. Then throws it at Johnny's face. And he's like, I'm buying you out. This is it. I want you out of my life forever. Johnny takes the check and he rips it off. He's like, no way. He's like, I'd rather be homeless than take money from you, Ed Asner, stepfather. Later on that night, Johnny is watching a movie on TV. As the movie gets into commercial, who's on the commercial? That's right, Daniel LaRusso, his arch enemy from LaRusso dealership, the car dealership. It's a car commercial, and he's like chopping prices and stuff, and this irritates Johnny Lawrence. He cannot take it no more. He gets his car keys, and he drives off into the night. Johnny then arrives at the All Valley Gym. That's where he lost in 1984 to Daniel LaRusso from that illegal crane kick. And as he's reminiscing about the loss and being beaten up by his ex-sensei, John Kreese, his car is T-boned in the parking lot by a bunch of teenage girls. He screams at the teenage girls. He looks in the back. He's like, open the door! Open the door! But they will not let him in. They are very scared, so they drive off. The car is eventually towed to, you guessed it, LaRusso dealership, where they're gonna fix his car. So the next day, he goes over to LaRusso dealership and he demands his car back right now. As he's waiting for the car, he overhears that Daniel LaRusso is coming out into the showroom. So he makes a quick exit. He tries to get out of there before he meets his arch enemy from 1984. Then Just as Johnny Lawrence is exiting the dealership, guess who's behind him? Daniel LaRusso. And they share this awkward moment where they hug, or Daniel hugs Johnny. He does not hug back at all. And then Daniel calls his fellow employees and he's like, hey, I want you guys to meet Johnny Lawrence, the guy that I beat illegally with my crane kick. So Johnny storms out of that dealership, but as he's leaving, he looks back and he sees a young girl hugging Daniel LaRusso, apparently his daughter. And he recognizes the girl from the car that T-boned him the night before. And now Johnny is steaming. He's like, my life is falling apart. I gotta get back to my roots when I was powerful, when I was confident, when I was Cobra Kai. He goes back home and he calls on Miguel and he's like, hey Miguel, remember at the convenience store when people were beating you up and they had the Pepto-Bismol on your head? I'm gonna help you out by teaching you karate, by opening up his own dojo. So Johnny goes back to the garbage, he finds the check, he puts it back together and he uses the money to buy his own dojo. And he opens up Cobra Kai. Cue the montage.
I'm not just gonna teach you how to conquer your fears. I'm gonna teach you how to awaken the snake within you. And once you do that, you'll be the one who's feared.
What's gonna happen next? I have no idea. Actually, I watched it all. All the episodes are on there. It's from a couple years ago. But if you guys wanna watch along with me, I'm gonna be recapping episode 2 of Cobra Kai next week.
You'll learn discipline. And when the time is right, you'll strike back.